Awesome. So Destination Imagination is a really fun program. You just do all these fun STEM challenges.
DI is really big on everything being child-driven. So as a manager, I'm allowed to intervene only to make things safe and only to teach kind of some umbrella concepts that will help our kids lead themselves to some solutions.
A lot of challenges you do is you build something, but then you incorporate some sort of performance or act into it.
It's hard to really capture everything that DI has given my own family, my own kids, and their friends who have been on teams with them. It's so much fun. There's so much opportunity for relationship building, for problem solving. It's just so great because you get to choose a challenge that you want to pursue finding solutions for and then working together to solve that.
I didn't know much about science and engineering before, you know, DI, and once we did it and we really figured out so many cool things that we could do.
And the opportunities might only exist for children and families who are able to create those opportunities themselves.
You walk away from DI learning so much more and having so much fun and even making new friends.
The foundation really shoulders the financial cost of that programming. And so if it were the responsibility of families to incur that fee, I'm not sure that families would decide to put their money there. Not because it isn't worth it, but because it's just such a gift to be able to provide these opportunities without that burden of the financial piece.
When it rains, it pours, but you didn't even notice.
I had returned from this awesome trip to the state of Wyoming where I was in the science camp and we were studying the creek and stream health. The idea was to study our creek health through macroinvertebrates. And so the foundation awarded me this grant and we were able to get microscopes and these mesh bags, and that was a really important part of the project, and these sorting mats. It can change the projectile of certain kids, even if it just changes their projectile for that day. So I've read about, there's something called, you know, the nature deficit, and this idea that kids just are not outside exploring enough. And that opportunity, and what I notice with kids is that when I do take them outside, when I do provide them these more hands-on physical experiences, it changes the course of their day. They are energized, excited, they're ready to learn, they're curious, they're going home and proactively trying to learn more and bringing stuff into me the next day. That's true learning to me. I could talk about one or two students, but the truth is it's blanket, it's over everybody when you provide these like project-based learning experiences for them. Plus, I think it cultivates, you know, working together in groups, it cultivates creativity, innovation, and just excitement around learning. So it was awesome, and we're still using it 3 years later today here at Mercer.
It ain't raining anymore. It's hard to breathe when all you know is.
And if you needed even extra help, you could always go to one of the teachers that was staying after school, and you could just like talk to them and ask them questions and like make sure that you knew what you were doing, like for the homework or projects or whatever, instead of just going home and like being stuck for like 3 hours, which is what I used to do before I joined 24/7.
And to me, I also made really good connections with the volunteers and the teachers there. I got to know them a little more after school hours, which was really important because until today I have really good connections with a lot of my teachers at Nagel.
And they will like stick to giving me the help that I needed until I understood what I was doing. So my grades eventually obviously went up, and I just felt a lot more confident in like all my subjects.
We really relied on that transportation to get home. Our parents worked from 11 in the morning to 9 at night in the restaurant, so they were not home at all until 9, and we had nobody to help us at home with our homework. It also really helped me to manage my time because it gave me a window of time that I could do my homework, that I could get help, that I could study for my tests. And because of that, and because of the help that I got, and because of the time management that I acquired through the program, today I am able to be involved in tons of opportunities outside of school. And also, I don't think I would have the same confidence that I do have in myself when things get tough, because that's what they also helped me learn, is that even when things get tough, like, you can figure it out.
The struggle of staying above the rising water line.
So the Alden Food Drive is an all-district collection. Each school is collecting for different pieces and parts that would be delivered to the inter-parish ministries. And so the kids stand there and solicit and offer a shopping list. Some people give cash donations, which is really kind, and then the kids do the shopping. But we have 4 weekends of collection now. Power packs go home with students all over our community and surrounding areas, of kids that might be on free and reduced lunch, that when they go home in the evening, their parents are maybe working, their pantries might be empty, there's no food on the weekend to eat. And so these packs go home with high school kids, elementary age kids. So one school might be in charge of just collecting shampoo and toiletries. Another school might be in charge of personal care items of one sort. Maybe another group might be collecting clothing. So everybody does their part.
Well, the sky is finally open. The rain and wind stop blowing.
Hope Squad is basically like a club or like a before school activity where we get together and we talk about suicide prevention, which is becoming a more relevant topic of discussion in our schools.
We have some persons from Child Focus come and give us what's called QPR training, which is question, persuade, and refer.
Hope Squad has really helped me know what to say and how to react.
And that way we don't like go overboard, like we're not meant to be counselors, we're just meant to refer students to a trusted adult.
Being in Hope Squad just really feels, it makes me feel like I have like a place to, I don't have to hold it all in myself anymore, because I can share it with other people who know what it's like to have somebody pour their heart out to you in a text, or you know what I mean? And it's like the burden's not all on my shoulders anymore, which is really nice.
There are some times where I might see a student who, you know, maybe they're just not having a good day, and maybe they're not necessarily thinking of taking their life, but they just need someone to talk to and just be a friend or say, hey, I think you'll have a great day. I know that everything's gonna be okay.
A lot of it, surprisingly, is through like phones. Like, I have never had someone come up to me in person and be like, I'm struggling. It's all like through social media, through texting, which is, it's really helpful to have Hope Squad, because again, I can be like, hey, what do you think about this? Or like, what should I say here?
They recognize me as someone who they can go to if they need help. And I love that experience.
But you're stuck out in the same old storm again.
When my child was born, of course, we don't have a manual for parenting. You just rely on experiences and sort of what you hope was the best from your own life and talking to friends. And with my daughter, I quickly realized she had some mental struggles. We started seeing Child Focus when she was 3 years old. And part of what was frustrating is I couldn't communicate with her. It's been our whole lives, and I will tell you that there are many days where I don't know that we're gonna make it at times, and if it weren't for that coaching and that support and that mentorship through Child Focus, we wouldn't even be here today. So Child Focus, for me, is an extension of just their day. They will allow them to work on breathing techniques, work on with anxiety to, I feel like this, but this is not necessarily what my brain is. My brain is telling me this, but I don't have to act on that. They break down a lot of things for the parents of your child's always at a 10 and you live at a 3, you know, and so they talk about real language so that you're able to work through things. The therapist at that time still checks in on Sarah all through all these years. We've known her. She's not currently her therapist, but she still wants to know how she's doing, where her struggles are, where her amazing, you know, that how much she's grown, and also the positive parts of her life. So although we have seen different therapists over the years through Child Focus, it was not ever a school thing. You see your little kindergartner laying there. You don't know if they're going to get up or if they're going to, if they can make it through the day. And you don't know what's going on. Are they sick? Are they whatever? And Forest Hills has done an amazing job. Their teachers were so caring and check-in. And a lot of her success has to do with just the teachers in her life. I teach middle school, and I wasn't sure. Those are the years that usually are the toughest on everybody. And she had such success emotionally, academically, and socially through that. So I thought we were in such a smooth sailing spot. And what you don't realize with mental health, it doesn't go away. So it's really difficult when you see your kids struggling and you can't fix it for them. It's not a Band-Aid. And that's where more therapy and just really a wraparound from everybody and getting everybody on board to understand what you're going through. Child Focus not only supports Sarah, it supports me because I need that comfort of knowing that these are the things that we're doing, we're working on this together, and it may not turn out the way you want, but at least you're being proactive. And it just gives you hope also that things will be fine, that she's gonna find the path and get where she needs to go.
You hold tight to your umbrella. Well, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head.
Please continue to give to the Forest Hills Foundation.
I think I just want to say again just how thankful I am that I was given that money, and I just hope the foundation continues on their mission. They're doing excellent work.
Right now, I feel like it's more of our friends and like our peers and people that we know on a personal level. But I feel like if we keep the program, then people who don't necessarily have personal relationships with us will be able to come to us and talk to us.
I don't think I would be able to have the resources and the tools without it.
'Cause the sky has finally opened, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck at